Hang on, you are 18. You're making a new album now. The Spice Girls are all.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's almost finished.
You haven't, because it's been 18 months since your last one.
Yeah, it's been a while.
So now you're going to do it again. Mm-hmm. Are you all together when you do it, or?
Mm-hmm. Usually.
Or one flies in, tapes a track?
No, we like to write all together.
Cause yeah.
There's just, I don't know, there's like the vibe between us. We like to think it's part of the magic that we share together.
Yeah.
But, you know, sometimes occasionally someone can't make it one day, but generally we're usually together.
So for this 18 months, this gives you more time though. The reason you haven't been making albums is because now suddenly you have more time to do your own.
Well, I think the first thing that happened that I made the final decision to go and do my solo record, because I always wanted to do it at one point, but when Melanie and Victoria became pregnant, and obviously they
How did that happen?
I keep asking them, but no one will tell me.
Yeah.
But when that happened, I just thought it was a perfect opportunity, because they needed time off, and you know, I had some, you know, inspiration.
Can the Spice Girls go on for a long, long time? In other words, your target audience was young people, teens, and you're all maturing. You know, you're moving in your own direction, which is probably musically even a step up, more creative perhaps than when you sing for younger people.
I think it's different. It feels different.
It feels, yeah.
You know, I'm in a different headspace when I'm doing, you know, the two things. But I mean, I don't know, who knows? I mean, it could all end tomorrow.
You started doing a duet, though. You did a duet with Brian Adams.
Brian Adams, yeah.
Yeah, how was that?
And it was fantastic. I love him. He's great. He's a really good mate now, actually.
Yeah.
And that was, you know, a lot of people think these things are planned, but it wasn't. I didn't plan to go duet, solo career. It was it just sort of happens. It was just fate. He just called me up and said he had a song that he thought I'd, you know, sound good on. And I was like, I didn't even know the song great. And he went, yeah, I'll do it. But, you know, Brian Adams.
And it was great.
Yeah.
It really worked well. Would you ever sing with your mom? That's not just a silly question. Your mom, I guess, maybe they don't know. Your mom.
Some people do.
Yeah, your mom's a pretty accomplished singer. She's has her own tour. She has a group.
Mm-hmm.
And she what does? Tina
your
Turner?
Your research is a jolly good,
I have
Jerry.
Spent the entire day in the library. That's amazing. Would you sing with your mom?
I've sang with her before. When I was at school, I sang with her. You know, growing up. I mean, that's why I started singing early. She was always singing around the house, and I just wanted to be like my mom.
Yeah.
But more recently, we've done something in New York, actually, because she was over there with her band at the Count Basie Theatre.
Yeah.
And I got up and we done When You're Gone, and she took Brian's part and I done Sporty's bit.
I'm looking at these tattoos. You're pretty serious about that.
I know. I think it's going a bit far now, isn't it?
How many do you have?
It's a bit ridiculous. I've got eight.
Eight?
That's the eight. But it's only tiny.
That's tiny.
It was
That's
just
a little
sort
star.
Of to commemorate, you know, the album.
Are there some that I can't see?
I'm not getting my belly out at the moment.
Okay. What, something you want to tell us? No.
No, just read the paper. Well, I've got that one.
Oh, that is lovely. What is it?
It's a lotus flower.
You and what? I'll be right with you.
Everyone's seen it.
Oh, my God. Yeah, what?
Tell you what, though, talking about papers, I have never had so much fun since I got this bum. Tell you, the fellas love it.
You think you're pretty good about tattoos, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to see if you can, because the tattoo is a reflection of the person.
Okay.
Okay, and so what we're going to do is, on the screen, this is easy. Okay. Well, no, it says you're very...
Mixed up.
Okay, so now what we're going to do, we're going to look at a tattoo on a famous person, and we're going to see if you can identify the person,
okay?
Let's
take
a look at the first one. I wrote these down so that I would know who it is. Okay, here's tattoo one. Now this is...
That's Melanie Black from All Saints.
Let's see, is it? Is it?
Yeah.
How did you know that? That'd be right.
Because I take notes of people's tattoos and, you know, I've met Mel before. She's a lovely girl and
lovely
fine. Torso
it's
and a lovely
tattoo.
We
gave
tattoo.
Her someone she knows. All right, next one. That's very good. What's that?
Oh, that's Jerry's back.
That's her back?
With some hair extensions just... You know, it's hype.
I love Jerry.
It's just, you know me. I just like having a laugh.
Of course. So you didn't mean that comment about the hair extensions, but you really love her voice.
Her hair extensions are dreadful, but it doesn't mean I don't like her. Look at me again.
I am the pot, and I call him the pet of black. Look at my head.
Okay. Okay, what do you think about her voice?
It's not to my taste.
It's not to your taste.
Oh, but I don't like my own voice.
Oh, you have a good...
I'm like Minnie Mouse.
You have a lovely voice.
Thank you.
Okay, one more tattoo. That actually is skull and bones on the side. You don't know who it is?
No.
Let's see. Oh!
Do you know what? I have a feeling now.
That is the original Posh Spice. I mean, that's really posh. There's your queen. That's it. She doesn't really have that.
I don't think you're allowed to do things like that in our country. I think you might get arrested now.
I didn't do it. They put it up on the screen. I swear. Okay, you know, I seem to know a lot. You know what? I don't know a lot about you, but I think I do. And a lot of people think they know everything about you because you, all the Spice Girls, among others, you live in these newspapers, these tabloids. Their stories.
I will be in a few years in a few cardboard boxes.
You know, we hear you can't go a week without seeing pictures, hearing stories.
Well, Victoria can't go for a wee without being in the papers. they're not too bad with me.
No, the rumors
are not too bad. But I mean,
what's the most ludicrous rumor they ever said about you?
Well, something that more recently I've found that's really annoyed me is the allegations about me being gay. Because I'm a very honest person.
Yes.
And I'm very honest with my fans and the general public, and I'm very helpful to journalists and everything, and they're trying to make me out to be a liar because I'm not going to come out because I'm not gay. You know, so I find that annoys me that they're trying to say that I'm deceiving people when I'm not.
Sure. So, there's nothing wrong with being gay, but you're saying...
Absolutely not. If I was gay, I would be proud and fighting for the cause because that's the kind of person
But there's no I'm. Point in saying you're gay if you're not. So guys still have a shot at you.
But you know, I thought it was a good move, because blokes like that, don't they?
You're sporty, Spice. Strong like bull.
I'm full of bull.
I'm the one that's full of bull, yeah. You ever think of coming out, like, with a video? Because, I mean, you're known for your workouts.
Nah, it's dead enough, that. Isn't it, though?
You what?
I'm no Claudia Schiffer, am I?
Who are you?
I'm me. No, I just think they're not.
But your workout routine is pretty extensive, though, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I swap and change. I did do a lot of strength training for a long time and got a bit muscular.
You think you're pretty strong? You think you could beat me in an arm wrestle?
I don't know. I can try.
Wait a second, they told me you were going to say no. Okay, first let me just say, I'm 56. I'm still jet lagged from flying over.
I was in Denmark yesterday, I'm jet lagged too.
It's a shorter flight. And I'm not real strong. God, what if I lose?
Oh, come on, let's have a go. You're the man, men have got more strength than women.
But if you can't beat a 56-year-old,
no, that's not the fact.
So what do we do? Is this how you do it?
Do you want to know the secret?
What are you down on one knee? Okay.
Because I'm really fine. The secret.
Okay, ready? Okay, when you hit the cymbal, we go.
No, the secret is, secret is with arm wrestling, don't try and get it down, pull it towards you. I'm such a pub bird, aren't I? But the thing is, I give you a hint about darts as well. What you want to do is, right? Ready?
Okay. Ready?
Yeah.
Set, go.
Yeah. I shouldn't have told you the trick.
Ladies and gentlemen, Melanie C. All right, we're going to hear from Melanie a little later on in the show. But my next guest is one of Britain's best loved and most enduring. Okay, to play us out tonight, it's Suddenly Monday from the soundtrack of the film Maybe Baby. Please welcome back the magnificent Melanie C.
Suddenly Monday, a stars, Lisa Riley, Atomic Kitten, Nick Moran, and of course the lovely Melanie C. We'll be back next week. Put it in your diary and make it a date. Until then, take care of yourself and each other. Good night.